Happy Wednesday, everyone. Today on the workshop, we're going to be continuing the build with 12 more steps from the Fast and Furious Dodge Charger RT sent over by Fanhome. They've been sending over the series. We're going to be getting all the way up to step number 70 today, working our way through things. The entire vehicle is built in 110 steps, so we are well into the build at this point. We're going to go over each set of the three monthly issues you'll be getting in this video, and then we'll go ahead and just start assembling things in order. We'll start with step 59. We'll go over the parts in 59. We'll show you how it all works. If you're not familiar with this system, you subscribe on Fanhome using the link in the description of this video. Then they will send you a couple issues to begin with to see if you like the kit. Then you will continue your subscription with four monthly issues coming out once a month. You'll get four magazines, you'll get four sections of the car to build that month, and then you will wait and you will get another four steps the next month. So I've got 12 steps to go through, three monthly issues. The first one up we'll look at is steps 59, 60, 61, and 62. The manuals are super nice on these. It's actually a full color magazine that tells you everything that's involved, and it says right in here 110 parts. So once we get to step 70, you know, we've only got like 50 parts or 40 parts left to go, if my mathematics are correct. In this one, we're going to start building more of the roll cage like you saw us leave off. You can see how nice the manuals are. I won't go through the manual for every single step, but they are very easy to follow. Nicely done, drawn out, tell you exactly where to do things, even where to pull your wires that we've been wiring things in off to the side to get stuff out of the way, how to assemble things, what you'll be left over with, and anything you should touch up since the last build and the description. So that's going to be those steps right there. Step number 59 is those roll cage parts, as you see them. Step number 60, more roll cage parts. Everything is packaged nicely. Step number 61 goes to the absolute biggest piece I've received for this model so far. Huge interior structure, and it's metal and it's heavy. Comes in a giant box. This thing, just this part's bigger than an 18th scale, being 8th scale. It's massive. All steel, die cast metal, so that's pretty cool. And then part number 62 is another huge slug of steel with a new screwdriver. They figure you might be wearing out the tips on the included screwdrivers. Now, I like to use a more mechanical, larger handled, more professional style screwdriver, but the ones included with the model will get it done. I just prefer to use something else. Let me grab the next four steps so we can look at those and get the build going. What we've got on the table now, see, it's a much smaller shipment. It all depends on what they're having you do each month. We're gonna do step 63, 64, 65, 66. So we'll take a look at what's gonna be involved in those steps next. Again, same kind of magazine. Everything is blown out. Each magazine will give you some cool information about location scouting, actors in the movie, people that you see around, and then they'll explain other things about car information. This one gets into what are xenon lights, how do they work, how do they install and stuff in cars. It's very interesting. I like to build the model and then take all the issues up to what I call the reading room, which is the head, the lavatory, and read through those while I'm doing my business. Steps 63, right here, just some very small steps in this one. Not everyone's gonna be a giant shipment. We've got a metal frame for that interior, we can easily tell, in step 64. Includes all the screws labeled as we need them. 65 is the exact opposite side of that interior or exterior shell. All, I can feel the weight, definitely feels like metal. And then step 66, it looks like we've got some glass. It's going to be plastic, of course, not real glass, but we've got the molded in shapes. We got some tape here. They must be using some sort of double-sided tape or whatnot to hold it in place along with screws and stuff like that. So that would be steps 63 through 66 that you would get in the next monthly issue after the one we just showed with that huge metal shell. Let me get the last issue up that we're going to be building in this video, and we'll get it on the table. Next up in today's build will be the final four steps of this video, 67, 68, 69, and 70. So we're up to the model year of the Charger. In the steps, we got 110 steps to go total, so we got 40 left on here. In steps 67, 68, 69 shipment, you will get a very large box again. This box for here for step 67, we can clearly see is a windshield frame and windshield glass with some 3M tape in here. That's step 67. And I like that frame on there. I can't tell by the weight if that's plastic or metal. I'm going to assume it's chrome-plated plastic because like the blower is and stuff like that in this model. Then we've got some side trim. I always have to do these in a silver Sharpie or a Molotow pen when I build my plastic models, but this one is just going to be a large piece. That's step 68. 69, of course, is the opposite side of the trim. Definitely got that Charger Coke bottle shape going on there. So that's step 69, and then another large box with a huge piece of metal in it. This is the exterior shell. Check out that rear window frame, getting down into those cut lines over the quarter panels. We've got the windshield frame. That's all one giant piece of cast metal. Look at the size of that thing. Huge, massive. That will be what you see on screen in step 67, 68, 69, and 70, so you can tell which ones I'm on when I get to them. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to lay a towel down on the table, get my camera mount out. I always tape a nice towel down on the table so that I don't scratch this kind of paintwork when I'm sliding it on here and putting screws in from the bottom and working on it. I don't want to scratch stuff. So I'm going to get that stuff set up. What you'll see me using are some screwdrivers that fit better in my large hands. And when you see stuff like this, this little injector, this is just a light machine oil. And when I have to do metal to metal connections, sometimes the nice thick paint that they spray on this body will get into those screw holes. So I will use the Lubit, the machine oil, to get in there and so I don't strip off any of those screws or break them off or strip the Phillips heads on them. So let's get to building. We're gonna jam out to some cool music.